Pasta Games. Famad, come here, little dude.
Arkanoid Eternal Battle for the Nintendo Switch.
Whoa, Eternal Battle, be the last survivor, 25 players online. Defeat Doe, one player local. Retro, one player local. What the hell? How do I play this?
Connecting to the game.
What the hell is this, like a, is this like Tetris 25 or whatever, Tetris 99? Move, dash. Waiting for other players. I don't think we're gonna get 25 people playing Arkanoid. Yeah, let's just do one player. Let's do Neo.
After stopping the unidentified lifeform invasion in Sector 9, the Arkanoid roams the galaxy in search of peace.
Whoop. Well, oh shit, there was an actual enemy. There's an enemigo. Dude, we used to play, when I say we, I mean my sister and I, my older sister and I, on our computer, I'm sure I've brought this up multiple times, but we had this, We had this disc that we got for, I don't remember where we got this disc from, but it was called like, 1,000 games or whatever. It was a bunch of demos is really what it was, shareware and some non-shareware stuff, but it was all on a CD disc, compact disc CD, whatever, CD-ROM. And goddamn. And so I think there was an interface for it that we could just, I could never get to install. So then the way I used it is just, I literally just went, I opened up the disc's contents and like looked up the, you know, went through the file folders and then like, you know, just installed, looked for installers and then did it that way, right? Oh my God, I'm gonna lose. Did I lose already?
Defeat.
Let's try again. Good Lord. Let's try again. And so the, because there was supposed to be an installer, like the actual folders that they came in, they were just abbreviations. They weren't like full on, you know, it wasn't like, it wasn't a thing where it said this is the game that's in there. It was just like abbreviations of the game. So like, for example, I remember one was called Micro Man, right? It was just like MICRM. Like basically like Micro M was the name of the folder. And then, you know, you just kind of would, you know, like open the thing and then use the installer, if, you know, if you felt up to it. And then, you know, see if it would install on your computer. And if it did, you would install it and then play the game. And like I said, a lot of them were sharewares and there, you know, but there was one that we found on there called Winbrick. And it was basically this. It was Arkanoid or Breakout or whatever you want to call it, since it's gone by different names throughout the ages. Was one of them, and it was called Winbrick. Winbrick 2000 or something, or Winbrick 97, something like that. And it was one of these kinds of games, and you would get power-ups and stuff, but it only went up to a certain level. Like, it didn't have a... It wasn't a fully-fledged game, because, like I said, it was a lot of them were just, like, demos or shareware or whatever they were called back then. And, yeah, I remember that was one of the ones that, like... Whenever, because we would have to like I'd have to uninstall stuff from the computer because it was what was like 2 gigs of storage back in the day. So to make room for stuff, whenever we would get like new games or new like stuff our dad would make us put on the computer, like encyclopedias or, you know, other stuff of the sort. Like, I'd have to delete stuff. And so it was always like, you know, because I'd install like a bunch of games and then just kind of leave them. And then until it got to a point where it's like, oh, no more fits, I have to just delete them all. And then, but one that I always looked for was Windbrick, because it was, I don't know what it was about it, but Windbrick just always, you know, it hit the spot. And it was basically this. And so the reason I reminded me of the, you know, the good old days of just classic Windbrick. Let's play retro. Whoa!
The era and time is unknown. After the mothership Arkanoid was destroyed, a spacecraft vows.
Alright. Well. Oh my god. I mean, Windbrick looked nicer than this. But, yeah, dude, it's just... It just reminded me of it, and that era of my life, which is so long ago. Like, ridiculously long ago. That was, what, like, late 90s? It's 2024. Like, late 90s was at least 25 years ago, right? So, if, like, that's crazy to me that, you know, this is what it was, and that's just how you use your computer. Is it still recording? I can't tell. The power went out for a second. I don't know what's happening. I don't know if it's actually still recording. It looks like it is, and there's like sounds. My TV is booting up because it's an Android TV. Let me see. Let's get my menu back up and see where I'm at. HDMI 1. Are we still here? Unable to... Oh. I mean, we can search for networks later. Whoa, the power went out, dude. Well, I died. The eternal battle mode is not accessible. Oh, eternal battle is Wi-Fi. I mean, I guess I can do versus? Cool. Okay, and then this is just multiplayer? Is it just like whoever survives the longest, or is there like an actual component where we can, where we do things to like hurt each other? Or what's the deal? Oh. Oh, I died, and so... Player 2 won the round. Oh, because they finished it first. Okay. I mean, I guess. Sorry, this... Okay, this... Yeah, this... Whoops. God damn it. Yeah, quit. I guess Neo is really the only mode I can play. Because one was like an online mode that had no players. And also, the internet went out. So that's not working. And then the other one was the multiplayer game, which was not really exciting. Then we have the classic mode, which is like, whatevs. And then we have this mode. So I guess if this is the mode it'll be. There was, on the Nintendo DS, they had one of these games. It was Arkanoid something, but it actually had a wheel that plugged in like a Game Boy cartridge on the second slot, and then that was you can basically use the wheel to control the game, and it was only for that game from what I know. Ugh. Damn it. I think it was only for that game. And I remember when DS was the thing, and not like 3DS or DSi or anything like that, just like the traditional original, oh geez, regular DS. I remember I got super big into all the different attachments you can get for the let me make sure this thing's still recording. Oh, it looks like it is. I got big into like the different attachments you can get. So like they had the Rumble Pack for Metroid, and they had they had like the, what was the other thing called? There was like the memory pack for if you had the Nintendo DS browser, which I never had. There was that like Arkanoid attachment thing that's probably worth a ton of money now because it was rare because it was Japan only. But I'm pretty sure it's even more rare now. There was like a piano attachment that I got for Janet, and like the game was like called Easy Piano, and like the, it was literally just a little mini one octave keyboard that would attach to your DS. There was like the Guitar Hero games where you had the like Guitar Hero controller attachment thingy. I also looked for games that were DS games that even if they didn't have like a full-on thing that you can do to them, where like a full-on like, you know, Rumble Pack or whatever, where they attach to Game Boy Advance games and they did something special with them. So like Mega Man Battle Network had, I think Battle Network 5 DS, depending on which game you put 1 through 5, the music in the game would change, and then you would also find like different items and stuff. There was also what was the name of the game? Lunar Knights for the DS, which was a Konami game, but there was a game called Boktai for the Game Boy Advance that had like the game itself had a solar sensor on it. So like if it was, because you were like a vampire hunter and you needed the power of the sun, so in order to like win at the game, you needed to recharge, or you would have to use the sun for like puzzles and stuff, and so that's where the sun sensor came in. But if you plugged that game in while you were playing the Boktai, I'm sorry, while you're playing Lunar Knights, it unlocked different things. And then I think if you had it plugged in when you played Mega Man Battle Network, like you unlocked a soul or double soul or soul cross or something, or you basically merged with this little hero, and then your Mega Man was like golden. Oh man, I'm blanking on what other stuff there was, but I got super into like games that had functionality that was extra depending on what you had. I think the, what was it called? Feel the Magic, the like launch mini game. It was like a WarioWare kind of game, but all the whole point of the game was that you were this normal guy and you were trying to impress this girl. And so you did all these like wacky mini games, and then all the wacky mini games were like your homies trying to like help you impress this girl. But I know that there was stuff depending on like if you had different Sonic games on it, because it was a Sega game. Like if you had different Sonic games in there, it would unlock different stuff. I think one of them was like literally like a Sonic hat that you could put on the girl, because the characters were just like silhouettes basically. So they had like, they were fully 3D models, but they didn't have any textures. It was just like, they were fully like black, like all black. They looked like silhouettes. And I lost again. And and I remember specifically looking for games that had that functionality, because I was just like, I want to see it. I want to know. Like the thought that like, this worked, you know, you can have like games recognize that they had games in them and then it would do stuff, that to me was always like, I don't know, just the idea behind the technology, which in reality is not like, if I were to think of it in terms of like how they put it together, it was probably just you know, the DS checks to see if a, like, let's say a ROM is loaded in the second slot, and if it is, boom, it like checks a box and it's like, cool, like, put this on there. It's not like the cart itself loaded any extra info into the game. It was just there as a check, you know, as like a, do you have this? Yes. If you do, okay, cool, you'll get this thing. If you don't, then you don't get this thing. I think that's all it was. But to me, like, the idea, it just reminded me of Sonic 3 and Knuckles, and how you can have a game serve multiple functions, which was always, I don't know why the idea just seems like a cool thing. Like, I still have hope one day, as it, you know, the hope has gone, has slowly died as I've gotten older, but like, to one day have something to do with like a video game, right, where like either I make one or I'm involved in the production of one, and like, you know, I'm able to hire someone to make it, and then I help them and we come up with ideas and whatever. Like, that to me has always been a thing. But I think of like, whoa, what the hell? I think of like stuff that I would want in my games, or my game, or games, if that ever happened. I'm like, it'd be cool if there was a way where like stuff you did, like if you had stuff from your first game and then it did something in your second one, right? Like, not like you get all your power-ups and then you're just super like killer at the game or whatever, but I don't know, something as like a bonus for doing stuff that was like only for people who played it and like beat it, you know? So I could like read your save file and be like, oh, you did this, and like, I don't know, you made this outfit with your character. Well, guess what? You can bring that outfit, even if that outfit doesn't exist in the second game. You can bring that outfit to the second game because you know, you spent time and you created it, or like things like that, right? Like, to where like no one would technically have all of the things, where it's like, oh, you have all this stuff from the first game and you can just mix and match it with the second. It's like, no, you can bring your outfit from the first game that you use, that you specifically put together and customize and everything, and then it's different than what another person did. Because I think that would be, I don't know, I feel like that'd be more unique than just like, you unlock these 10 new hats, do what you want with them. And like, instead of that, it's like, no, what if they just unlock the one hat that they use the most, or something like that, right? I don't know, I think it'd be neat. Just ideas, you know, because I'm like, oh man, if I can make a game, I'm like, I'd make a platformer and like this, that, and the other. But also I'm like, also I feel like I'd want to make a rhythm game that just feels fun. It feels like something I'd like I'm ready right now. If anyone's listening knows how to make video games, I want to make a rhythm game. We can put it on the Switch, we can put it on your phone, I don't care. I just think it'd be rad. I'm like, I will draw the doodles for it. Whoa, that's new. Like, tell me what you need to get it going and I'll get it going. Like, that is such a life goal that like I need it made, that like I will do whatever I have to do. No, you better not, you stupid brick. Okay, I'll do whatever I have to do to make sure it happens. I don't know, that'd be dope, man. That would be dope. Let's see, let's make it bounce around. Yeah. Like, why do one block when you can do many? Let's do this side again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Uh-oh, no! The thing that I had was really good. Uh-oh. Why is that bar like all the way at the top? Oh shit. No. We're doing so well. Don't die. There's no like slowdown. I wonder what that does. What the hell was I talking about? Oh yeah. Tell me what I gotta do to make a game, and then I'll do it. I will do it. I need it. I need to do it. I need to make friends with people who know how to do programming and video game stuff. I need it. All right. Well, I mean, 20. I mean, I'm not at time, but like, I'm about as close to time as I need to be. Like, I'm good. It's fucking Arkanoid. Like, you know what this is. I'm sorry that that was weird with the power going out and kind of losing there for a second. It looks like nothing got lost. Like, everything still looks like it captured. So I'm confused, but optimistic. So I guess we'll see. Am I still offline? I am offline still. No, I think we're back. Maybe. The eternal battle mode is not accessible. Maybe it will be. Maybe you're going to come back on. Yay. Look at that. It's back on. I mean, control sensitivity, rumble, crossplay, whatevs. That's it for, what's this game called? Arkanoid. What is it called? Eternal Battle. Seems like if it's going to be a battle royale game, it feels like it should have just been free. Kind of like Tetris 99 and stuff. But what do I know? I'm just a consumer. If you didn't know, there's a little boy named Cheeto on my lap. He was crying earlier because he was cold. Now he's on my lap. He's just happy. But yeah, that was Eternal Battle Arkanoid for the Switch. That's all right. Whatever.